Hey everybody, let me see, are we going live here? I think we are. All right. Hey, welcome to MiniGovGuide GIS Lunch and Learn event. I am your host, Toby Soto. I am the blogger behind MiniGovGuide.com, and I am also the GIS manager for the city of Riverside in California. I do these Lunch and Learn events in order to help you go from good to great with actionable content from my shared experiences and my conversations with GIS professionals like you and also GIS industry experts. Just to state this, that my discussions and thoughts are of my own and not of my employer. So today's topic is less leadership and a little more on the technical side. Today I'm going to review the ArcGIS Enterprise 10.5 components that Esri just announced not too long ago. I'll break it down at a high level. I won't go into like massive detail. Maybe that can be a future episode later on as we maybe break down some of these components. So ArcGIS Enterprise is replacing ArcGIS Server, and the marketing material for what Enterprise is, let me read that to you. It says, the Esri WebGIS pattern comes to life through ArcGIS Enterprise, where it enables server-based big data and raster analysis, access to maps and apps on the web, desktop, and your mobile devices, and opens the door to new ways to collaborate and share geospatial content. So the ArcGIS Enterprise stack is composed of certain components, and the main component is the ArcGIS GIS server. That's the nucleus of the Enterprise ArcGIS Enterprise server. And basically that is the core web services components for maps and for map making and performance analysis. And then we have the portal for ArcGIS, that's the second component, and that's the sharing component of maps and apps within the organization. The third element is the ArcGIS data store, and that's the data storage for hosted and federated servers in your portal. And you're probably asking, what is a federated server? Glad you asked. That is additional, as is adding additional ArcGIS server sites to your portal, and that enables you to have user identity authentication, maybe using simple single sign-on capabilities. You also enable security through the portal and not by the individual server sites. So that's what the federated servers are. The fourth component to the Enterprise is the ArcGIS Web Adapter, and that integrates ArcGIS GIS Server and ArcGIS Portal with your web server. So it brings all the pieces together. The way you deploy this, you can either be all on-premise, you can also have it in the cloud utilizing Amazon Web Services or Microsoft Azure. You can also do a hybrid, which is partially on-premise, some of it on web, on the cloud. The functional capabilities are broken down into server roles, and they're deployed by the GIS server. So they're not so much extensions, but they're now consumed as roles, and they're being controlled and configured by the GIS server. And those five roles are, one of them is being the ArcGIS GIS server itself. The second one is an image server. The third one is the geo event server. The fourth one is the geo analytics server. And the fifth one, which is a new one to me, is the now Esri business analyst server. So that's all now compiled under the GIS server and triggered and configured to utilize through that. The base deployment for on-premise, let me just signify this. On-premise, your base deployment on your infrastructure would include the ArcGIS GIS server, portal for ArcGIS, the data store, and the web adapter. And that's basically bringing WebGIS into your organization behind your firewall. You can have this all on a single server, or you can have it on a distributed architecture where, you know, each one of these roles are on separate servers. And it also supports high availability. The licensing is still through the named user licensing. You have level one and level twos. Level one are your basic users that consume and read the content. They can view information. Level two are your creators and those that can share the content through the enterprise. There are four user entitlements based on the enterprise component level that you're employing. You have Enterprise Advanced, you have Enterprise Standard, ArcGIS Enterprise Workgroup Advanced, and ArcGIS Enterprise Workgroup Standard. And the Workgroup Advanced, from my understanding, it's capped at 10 level 2 users. So I believe once you get to 11, 12, maybe higher, then you have to go to the Enterprise Standard or maybe Advanced to acquire more licensed users for that. Check with your account manager. All of that can change, I'm sure, based on your ELA or however your packages are set up. So by all means, don't take my final word on any of that. So that's it for this week's edition of GIS Leadership Lunch and Learn. I hope this provided you a little primer into this new platform, and I guess in a way of saying that we're going from ArcGIS Server to now an enterprise platform and collaboration between components. For more information on GIS Leadership, you can go to www.munigovguide.com. You can catch these Facebook Live events every Wednesday, 12:30 Pacific time. And you can also catch the replays on Facebook and YouTube. Anyways, I'll see you guys next week. Take care.